So I took the first section on this side, I went over again 7.5 from the center, and you can see I have that grouped. So what I can also do is I can snip this now, and I can take each section. Of course, if your rattle is 1-inch sections, then when you were doing your warp, you would have tied it off into 1-inch sections, making it a lot easier to put over top of your rattle. Now I have to admit, when I first did this, this is not something I did on my own. I was doing a demonstration for some of my friends, and one of the women in the group said, "Oh, my instructor taught me to do it this way." Voila. That's what I do now. So I'm going to continue with this, and once this is finished, then I will go to the next section. There we are. All separate section. Don't have to worry about trying to count how many threads. Now the next thing I might want to do is come down underneath here. It's kind of hard to see, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to spread these out, make sure that they're on the rod even. This is so it will all wind on nice and smoothly. I also will just start to wind this just a little bit, just to get it started on the first crank before I put some paper or cardboard or whatever you want to use, or leaf sticks, whatever your preference is. I happen to like some corrugated cardboard. So we're going to pause here for a moment until we get the cardboard, and I will show you